down the road. You'll follow me down. Just keep it on the pilot jet. In other words, very slow.
No wheelies.
No, I just have to tell this guy that man, he wheelied the thing.
Did he really? I'm just joking. Okay.
Walk the course.
Okay. Walk it as in on my legs.
Yeah,
hello.
It's almost impossible
if I move to
the left. Yeah. Yeah, kickstand's on your right.
Where is it at?
Yeah, you'll probably have to put it down with your hand because it tucks in underneath.
Ah! Hold that. My boot's in the way. Okay. I know.
Okay, here's the deal. Because you got to get the bike narrow, going through rocks and roots.
Right.
If the kickstand was on this side, you would have to be out like this.
Right.
So you would actually lose clearance.
And the shifter's so far forward.
Exactly. So when you go in, just like at a trials, like right here, when you come into a section, so this is what they call a starting gate.
Yeah.
You'll never change gears. That's why it's important that you walk every section.
Right. First, yeah.
In a trials, you're never going to be shifted.
You just keep it in there and go.
Yeah, because if the thing in a trial, they'll have 9 different sections set up.
Right.
Ride it 3 times, 3 loops.
Okay.
So you'll never shift. Only time you're going to shift the trials bike is when you're going from one section to the next.
Okay.
You're going to look at what's in front of you, because remember in trials, every time you put your foot down, that's 1 point.
Right.
And you're only allowed 5 points per section.
This looks, it looks hard. I've always wanted to ride one of these, though. Never had the chance.
Okay, well, if you don't want to ride the section, you stay there.
Oh, I'll do it. I'm not.
Here's the only place that you, this is the hardest part about it.
Okay.
Don't go down that way.
Okay.
That's the hero section.
Okay.
The only place you're going to have the front wheel.
Yeah.
On that roof. When you come around here, this comes up quicker than you think it does.
Yeah.
The key to it is a throttle control, clutch, and your brake. What you're going to want to do, you're going to roll over the log, and it's going to tend to throw you over there.
Okay.
What you actually want to do is roll over, and then start working your way.
Okay.
You can ride the ribbon really close.
Okay.
Swing out, that way you ain't got the bars cut all the way.
Okay.
So use up all the course that you can. You want to try to get it over here.
Okay.
Swing out wide. You're going to want a 10 to go right here.
I'm nervous. No, I want to do it. If I mean, how bad can I mess up, right?
You've never seen me ride. I mess up bad.
Well, great. Now I'm encouraged.
Charlie, she's never ridden a trials bike before. Today's her first day.
Okay.
Today's my first day ever on a motorcycle, period. I'm just kidding.
No shame
in putting your foot down. Right? Okay. Okay.
Whatever makes you comfortable.
Okay.
All right, you're all right.
You're right. I did want to go that way.
Yeah.
Oh, you're going to hear it.
look like my first time.
Hard to get out of that mentality, ain't it? Good job. You're gonna be wore out.
You know what? If you want to talk to Charlie, he's a trainer.
Yeah.
He can kind of help you with some things.
Okay.
That's up to you.
Okay.
Okay. First thing is vision. You want to look like a bike length and maybe that much more ahead.
Okay.
And then you look two or three bike lengths ahead and then as far as you're going in that direction.
Okay.
And like here, that direction would be clear up to that corner up there.
Right.
If you went around the bottom tree, you can see all the way to that corner. So you see there's no log, no rock, no
obstacles.
Obstacles. So your brain now can get comfortable.
Right.
Okay. So on your arches, you only have knee speed. And it's so slow and it don't work well.
Right.
So so you want it where you have to bring about you. Straight foot parallel to the bike is the one doing the job. So if you're riding through rough stuff, you know, rocks angled like this, if you got a toe out or a heel in, your bike's always gonna shove out from under you on the downhill side. You know, it'll do that.
Right. Right.
If you think about your body as a rectangle from your feet to your shoulders, when you make a turn, you want to become a parallelogram. You from over here.
Right.
And the archer's elbow, if you're holding, you know, shooting a bow, if you're holding on to handlebars.
Right.
See what
straight.
This just did for you?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. And the other way over here.
Right.
You hold on to the handlebar, you have an archer's elbow.
Yeah.
It puts your body left to right, forward to back where it needs to be on the motorcycle so that you're in contact. You're coming out here, this is your travel limiter. The bike goes against the calf, the bike goes against the calf.
Okay.
And that way, if you're free on the bike, it'll rattle under you. If you've got it locked into a calf, then the obstacle has to pick up you and the bike.
Right.
So it's much harder to do.
I have the same problem. I've always been taught to steer the bike with my knees.
Yes. No, you throw it out.
He's trying to teach me to ride bow-legged.
Yeah.
And it makes sense.
Yeah.
Once I try it, I feel incredibly stupid doing
Yeah,
it.
You're looking like this.
I make it.
Yeah.
One more thing.
It doesn't
Put
stop.
Put big wooden bars. Yep. Straight-legged. Don't let me push you over. Okay. Now go bow-legged.
Bow-legged, yeah.
Bring that foot in just a second.
There you go.
Wider. That's wider.
Yeah.
Okay. Now don't let me push you over.
See?
Yeah.
Gravity doesn't work then.
Same here. Put big wooden bars.
Oops, wait a minute. Let me get out of the way of the bike.
Yeah. Okay. And I can take one finger and push you over. Now just roll your weight to the outside of your feet.
Bring
no.
A bit.
Not like that. Just roll the weight to the outside.
Okay.
Of your feet.
Yeah.
Now don't let me push you over.
See?
Yep.
See the difference?
It's a big difference.
As the bike gets bigger, this gets more important.
Okay. I get it. I honestly don't know what the heck even happened up there. I just went.
Guess what? This thing will do a complete steering.
Maybe that's what
that's
it. I think that is what it did. Yeah.
If you don't have your positioning right, that front end will just not.
I think that's what happened because I didn't. I was like, what in the world?
The day before yesterday, I had 5 guys go over the bars on that log.
Seriously? Wow.
I was contemplating on taking the log.
Yeah.
Thought,
well, it does throw you because you're right. You come off of that and you go directly because I think it's the angle of the log, too. Is it?
Watch him go all the way out.
Yep.
Well, he could have went further.
Yeah.
Man, 70 years old.
Incredible.
Ride some more or not?
I can.
That's up to you.
Well, I know you got people waiting too.
Yep, you've only put in how many laps?
Two.
You're owed at least two more.
Okay.
And you need to ride after
what he just said, yeah. Right. It was the throttle right there. I was like,
yeah.
Just that, you gotta just baby it.
Yeah,
it is touchy. and I had that problem right there. Touch the tree. Oh, see, it's so touchy.
When you're going across the flat up there, as high as you get, you're coming across the flat.
Yeah.
There's really nothing there to control.
Right.
Good-looking woman says your breakfast is getting cold.
Right here.